Chapter 4. Feeling sluggish. Not finding the underlying cause and treatment can be a hazard to your health. I would hazard to guess that the majority of the population feels somewhat sluggish on a regular basis. If one goes through this condition for a long time, it may begin to feel like this has become a normal situation for you and you become used to it. But not finding the underlying cause and treatment can be a hazard to your health. If you are feeling sluggish, then it is a warning sign that something is not right, and an immediate investigation is in order, as to the cause. There can be many different reasons for this condition. Many of the things we do on a daily basis absolutely poison our system. If you are a smoker, you definitely need to detoxify. As time goes in with many or several detox programs, you may find you've come to a point where you can more easily quit. Here are some of the causes of sluggishness. 1. Diet is of great importance. With all the pesticides and chemicals in our food today and nutrient-deficient soil, it can be difficult to get the nutrients we need to live a healthy life. It is possible to regain good health by changing your diet to eating organic foods that include eating more raw fruits and vegetables and less cooked food and sugar products. You may want to consider good supplements to obtain nutrients you might not otherwise get. You may argue that organic food is so expensive, but consider this: you may save a few bucks on cheaper packaged food that may be loaded with preservatives, nitrates, etc. But what is your health worth? How long do you expect your body to function correctly if you put degraded fuel into it? You've seen what it can do to a car. It is also so with your body. If you take a close look at healthy-looking celebrities that are trim and fit, they have a secret you don't. Being that their income is dependent on their personality and good looks, they are forced to forego the usual diets of the average American. They work out, eat smaller portions, and include a lot more raw foods, plus they drink a lot of water, and this brings up the next subject. 2. Dehydration. About 80% of Americans are semi-dehydrated and don't even know it. Without this precious liquid, our bodies, which are two-thirds RDS water, cannot function right. Dehydration alone can make you sluggish. If you are dehydrated, that means that the water level in your body is below normal for proper function. The handling for this is to increase your fluid intake. The best is just pure water, about 8 cups per day. If drinking that much water seems too difficult, you can up your water intake with green or herbal teas. These teas have a beneficial effect in that, as well as increased water intake, they also provide antioxidants which help your immune system. So drink up and feel better. 3. Through poor diet, lack of exercise, viruses, bacteria and parasites, digestive problems can occur. Here we have a whole host of problems to deal with. If your body is toxic, then your liver and kidneys may be on overload. You can handle a lot of this with a liver and kidney cleanse. Dealing with parasites. Parasites can reside in any major organ of the body and cause more problems than just sluggishness. Handle parasite infestation first, possibly using an herbal solution found at your local health food store, followed by a kidney cleanse, and then a liver and colon cleanse. This is a course recommended by Dr. Hulda Clark. There are many different cleanses you can do. To find the one that is right for you, go online and type in liver or kidney cleanse and carefully check out what is right for you. 4. Other ways to detoxify are fasting and enemas. Fasting is a centuries-old natural healing technique that works very well when done properly. Coffee or lemon enemas are great for cleaning out the colon from old and impacted feces. Certain herbs can also be helpful in cleansing the colon, such as cascara sagrada, in moderation, aloe vera, flaxseed, and red raspberry. Get plenty of fiber, with lots of water. This helps to keep you regular. An over-toxic colon can eventually put impurities into the bloodstream, and this will definitely make you feel sluggish. 5. There has been a lot of controversy over the years about too much mercury in your teeth. A dentist once told me that if you look inside your mouth, the fillings that you have may look smooth on the outside, but if you could look on the underside of the filling, it is quite a different story. It looks very jagged and the metals may be leaking into your system. Mercury in the system is the most toxic non-radioactive metal in the body, and about half of the silver fillings are mercury. A variety of health problems can occur, such as brain, kidney, and lung damage, and has even been linked to autism. You can be tested for metal toxicity through hair and urine analysis. If you test positive, you may want to consider having them removed and replaced with gold fillings. Even after replacement, though, it can take the body months to excrete these toxins. Do your research and find a dentist with an excellent reputation, who has done replacement fillings. For an interesting tidbit, a friend told me his mother had suffered headaches for 20 years, and after having all the fillings replaced, she no longer had headaches. 6. A relatively new technology has come out for detoxing the body, and that is with an ionic foot bath. You place your feet into a tub of warm water with a bit of sea salt in it. The ionic foot baths work by sending a small current that goes in a circuit through the body and generates positively charged ions. The high concentration of the ion field attaches to the negatively charged toxins, neutralizing them, and the body is then able to discard them through the approximate 2,000 pores that are on the bottom of your feet. You can then experience the correct acid-alkaline pH balance as nature intended. It's painless and takes about 30 minutes. The water will change color according to the toxicity of the body, and also by how hard or soft the water is, wherever you are, geographically. Watercolor indicators for body organs detoxing: black or brown, the liver. Orange, the joints. Dark green, the gallbladder. Yellowy green, the kidneys or urinary tract. White foam, the lymph nodes draining. Red flecks, blood clot material. Black flecks, heavy metals. Also, independent studies have been done that show the levels of mucus, heavy metals, and fat in the water after 30 minutes. Help take away that sluggish and fatigued feeling. As you can see, there are many things you can do to help take away that sluggish and fatigued feeling. But as always, consult your healthcare practitioner before doing any detoxification program.